Hello friends, I am back again with homeopathic medicines for your first aid kit. So I'll continue with Silesia. Silesia is an excellent remedy for the splinters, for expulsion of the splinters. Expulsion of splinters which may be embedded in your skin or in the body, or also expulsion of any foreign body particles inside the body. It is used frequently in 30 potency and according to the requirement. Then next remedy is urtica urens. Urtica urens, it is usually indicated in the pollen season, especially for the allergic reactions or allergic skin reactions, where the skin appears to be red and granular and there is a lot of itching. There is the rashes, red rashes found on the skin, and it can be given to eradicate that rash and the itching which is present. And this, especially this rash which is seen with a white spot in the center of each granular looking eruptions, and it itches intolerably. So this is particularly indicated in the pollen season, where such kind of large allergic reactions are found on the skin. Next remedy is Eupatorium perfilatum. Eupatorium perfilatum, it is indicated in cases of cold, coryza, headaches, which is associated with acute bone pains and joint pains. This patient usually comes after exposure to cold air, and this is also indicated in the areas where chikungunya or dengue is prevalent. So when a patient comes with acute bone pains or the acute pains where even the painkillers have failed, and this patient is surely helped by this medicine, Eupatorium perfilatum. Then is the nausea and vomiting, which is also indicated along with this nausea, vomiting, diarrhea, which also accompanies this all other symptoms. In this case, Eupatorium perfilatum is perfectly indicated. Then is phosphorus. Phosphorus is indicated in cases of bleeding, which stops the bleeding instantaneously, and the bleeding is usually bright red, and you have to take care that investigations have to be done to find out the exact cause of the bleeding. So as a first aid remedy, phosphorus can stop the bleeding instantaneously. Then is ipecac. Ipecac is a very good remedy where there's a lot of cough in the chest and there is associated nausea and vomiting. Whenever the patient tries to expectorate, he coughs up along with nauseating feeling, and here the ipecac is a very good remedy which will stop that kind of vomiting and nausea associated with the cough which is present in the chest. And next remedy is the pulsatilla. Pulsatilla is also called as the female remedy. It can be used in children as well, and the special indication here is that the patient is very clingy and in weeping. The patient is weeping in nature, and the patient either wants a fresh air and is quite thirstless as well, and here the pulsatilla is indicated. The patient feels better by consolation. That is one of the symptom here. So in cases of eruption of teeth, or in cases of menstrual problems, the menstrual pain, which we call as dysmenorrhea, the pulsatilla can be given. And the variety of symptoms and constant changeability in symptoms is one of the indication here in pulsatilla, along with the clingy and weepy nature of the patient. So pulsatilla is a very excellent remedy which can be kept in the first aid box and can be given as required. Then is carbovege. Carbovege in homeopathy, we call it as a corpse reviver, because it has helped many people to revive from that deathly experience. So here the patient feels cold and prostrated and wants to be fanned. Actually, the patient is going into a hypoxic state, and in this condition, when you give a dose of carbovig, the patient gets revived, and the patient may be going into a cardiac arrest as well, and it will help the patient till the ambulance and the help arrives. So this is one of the very good medicine. The patient may have the acidity, belching, bloating of abdomen, and all these symptoms are associated along with the prostrated, pale, sickly appearance of the patient. Then is the antim tart. Here the patient is cold and blue and becomes lifeless, has a full of expectoration in the chest, and there is a deathly rattle. There is a sound in the chest which usually happens in cases where there is a lot of cough accumulated in the chest, and there is a noise which can be audible by the people around, and that kind of patient is antim tart. There will be pungent odor from the body as well, and a lot of mucus accumulated in the chest with a deathly rattle. There will be slow reaction, and the patient is very weak and unable to respond, and antim tart is a very good medicine in this condition. Then is opium. Opium, when the pain, wherever the pain is expected, but the patient doesn't show any symptoms of pain, and there is complete numbness, there is no expression of pain, and usually this kind of symptom is found as a after attack or after effect of the shock, a numbed out feeling, and there is an extreme drowsiness, cold sweat will be found, and there will be shallow pulse. So here opium is a very good medicine. So you can give opium whenever such kind of symptoms are found in a patient. Then is a cocculus. Usually we give cocculus petroleum in cases of car sickness and seasickness. So cocculus is a most prescribed remedy for car sickness or seasickness. People who go on cruises or on a long travel journey by car, they have the symptoms with nausea, dizziness, which will be usually worse after the smell or sight of food, and the patient can't tolerate the smell of food or the sight of food. There will be an empty and hollow feeling in the stomach, which is very much a keynote symptom where the cocculus is indicated. Then the petroleum is there. The petroleum is usually indicated where there is a stiff neck. There will be pain in the neck, and the patient is unable to move the neck. There will be nausea accompanied along with the stiff neck and pain, and this kind of feeling is usually worse when they are exposed to light or noise. So here the petroleum is indicated. It may also get worse. The symptoms may get worse when the patient is in a lying down position and tries to sit up from that position. This is one of the indication where the symptoms are aggravated. And these symptoms may temporarily get relieved after eating. This is one of the keynote symptom. So petroleum is indicated whenever these symptoms are present in the patient traveling or having a traveling sickness or the cervical spondylitis as well. Then next remedy which I am going to explain you is the rescue remedy. Rescue remedy is a essential remedy which has to be in every first aid kit. So rescue remedy is a bag flower remedy. It's made up of the bag flowers and combination of bag flowers, and it helps as a rescue medicine. Whenever a patient collapses, is unconscious, has fainted because of any reasons, here giving a few drops of rescue remedy will revive him from that condition till help arrives. So these are some of the medicines which I have explained to you all for the first aid kit, homeopathic kit. If you have any queries regarding these medicines, you can contact me. You may also contact your nearest homeopathic doctor for any queries or any help you need. I finish off this first aid homeopathy and signing off till we meet again.